Hello, everyone. I'm Dawid Kurowski, and I'm working as a... Oh, where's the switch? I want the switch. Oh, yeah. And I'm working as a marketing assets producer at 11-bit Studios. We are a small developer and also publishing studio located in Warsaw, Poland. You can know us from our latest production, This War of Mine or Anomaly series. Right now, we are working on our newest project called Frostpunk, and we are publishing two games, BitCop and Tower 57. But let's get to the topic. To introduce those of you that may not know anything about This War of Mine, I can tell you that this is the game about civilians trapped in the city under siege. Player controls a small group of civilians that find shelter in one of the abandoned buildings in the city. Because of military blockade, it is unable to leave the city. So in this environment, player and his civilians will face hunger, violence, pointless deaths, and more other tragic events. Ultimate goal is really simple. You just have to survive the war. And the main topic of today's lecture is creating effective video game trailers in reference to marketing strategy. Entire presentation is based on This War of Mine, This War of Mine trailers and marketing assets that we've made to promote the game. So creating video trailers for your game is, I think, just as important as making the game itself. That's why you should start thinking about them from the very beginning. In my opinion, the first trailer should be a teaser. And you can show many things by teaser, but the main thing that should be shown is the subject of the game. Tonality, character, and visual side as well. But as you know, in teaser you can't show too many things because you just have to interest the audience and make them stay with you as long as possible. You can achieve this by making few important things, and the first one is proper music. It's really important to use proper music that match your production. And in our first trailer, we've used Pearls in Her Hair, the rock ballad performed by a Hungarian band called Omega. This band is more known in Europe than in other territories, but everyone liked it, and many viewers were asking us, oh, who made this? We wanted to know the authors of this cool track. In other trailer, we used a beautiful song called Nights in White Satin, performed by the Moody Blues. But my favorite one, honestly, is the Polish song that we have used in our gameplay trailer. It was really great experience to see that you can use Polish song in Polish game, and everyone loves it. Even if they don't know words in the song, they loved it. Appropriate music selection is, in my opinion, very, very important thing, and you should pay so much attention to this because it will highlight emotions, words, and style of your game. Also, second important thing that you should think about is the director. This invisible guy can expand the whole experience of your trailer. He can tell those things that viewer won't see at the beginning, at the first sight. So the good actor should have characteristic voice and also memorable voice. We were using many good actors in our trailers, but in my opinion, the one was the best because we used the real guy. And this guy also was in our trailer. He was the real survivor from the siege. Also, good actor can catch the attention of the viewers. By saying only first few words in the trailer. And that thing happened in our gameplay trailer, where first words were like, for soldiers, war is about victory. For us, it was about getting food. And after that, viewers wanted to see the rest of the video. So, let's move to the visual side, to the colors. I think colors and color grading in every video production are very important, and you can show many different emotions in one frame only by changing the colors. So let's watch the first trailer I've prepared for you today.
Nights in white satin, never reaching the end. Letters I've written, never meaning to send. Beauty I'd always missed with these eyes before. Just what the truth is, I can't say anymore, 'cause I love you.
So, as you can see, you can emphasize something by reducing saturation, adding some grain, and some other distortion filters. And on the other hand, you can make something brighter and more colorful, maybe a little bit smoother, to show the big difference between those two worlds. We did the same in this trailer that you are watching right now. So let's move to the cliffhangers. You'll see mostly them in TV series, but you can also use them, use the same visual creation in trailers. You just have to make a breathtaking scene and then just cut it just before the final frame. If it's good, everyone will lose their minds and start thinking and talking about what will happen next, what will happen in the next trailer on, or even in the our game. We made a few of them in our trailers. The first one is this. In this scene, this guy was running through the abandoned school, and after opening the last door, he ran out on two armed guys, and after this, we cut everything. There was only black screen and end slates. You can only imagine what happened after. On another trailer, there is a scene at the end of the trailer where armed soldier is saying something to a terrified girl and walking out of the shop with her. After that, we don't know what happened, and we can only imagine what he could do to her. This last one is very similar to the first one, but the picture, the video was really nice, corresponding to the music and voiceover, and the movement, camera movement was really, really nice. But this one, I think this one is better in perception than the first one. So. Details. Details are something I like the most because they can provide you this one most important thing to the trailer, and you have to pay so much attention to small details. For best video reception, you have to make everything perfect. Video cuts have to be perfectly matched to the music, and voiceovers have to be perfectly matched to the video. Only then you'll have ideal composition, and the audience reception of your trailer will be really, really good. So let's move to the punchlines. Punchlines are something we really like to use in our trailers. It's something that in our productions is used to say and show how emotional our game is and how tough topic we are trying to show to the bigger and wider audience. By punchlines, we are trying to show you very obvious things, but also those are things that you are not thinking about much on a daily basis. That's why we wanted to show players that in war, not everyone is a soldier, because that's true, and that helped us to make everyone remember that it won't be another game with soldiers in the foreground. Another one, really nice, is that we wanted to show that in war, kids are still kids, because even when the bombs are falling out of the window, they still want to have fun. They still want to have their toys and be happy. And the final and most thought-provoking punchline, I think, is that war always happens at somebody's doorstep. And that's true, because, you know, war can happen everywhere and anytime. So, let's see some more videos that I promised you. So, in this War of Mine, we've decided to make a teaser in which we have shown running and fighting soldiers seen from the perspective of the civilians. It was really important for us to show that at the beginning of marketing campaign, because we wanted to inform players that that it will not be another game where you can shoot at everything and have good time. In our teaser, you could see that war is hell, and behind all those tanks, shots and soldiers, there are innocent and helpless people. Also, we wanted to show characteristic for our game, Charcoal Style, which you can see on the last few frames of the teaser. Another goal for us was to leave viewers with insufficiency, and we have achieved this because they wanted to see more. They wanted even to pay us before the game came out, and without seeing even the gameplay. It was really great to see those comments. Right now I'll show how we try to show in video the tough choices that player have to make in game. Please be patient, because it's gonna be three videos in a row.
I shouldn't have gone out that night. It was so damn cold. I ran into other scavengers. They kept their distance, and I kept mine. A soldier approached me, his mouth twisted into a vicious smile. I did as he ordered. I was paralyzed. No one did anything to help me. I was alone.
Okay, so let's help the girl.
I had to go out that night. You see, we were running out of food. It was very hard to find anything. And then, I just wish I'd never seen it. I would have rather turned around and walked away. But sometimes, you just do what you gotta do. I had to go out that night. You see, we were running out of food. It was very hard to find anything. And then, I just wish I'd never seen it. I didn't help the girl. I couldn't. I hope you'll understand it one day.
Okay, just like in the game, in our mobile announcement trailer, viewer is forced to make a decision. For this announcement, we have decided to make gameplay trailer with a story, but at the end of the trailer, a viewer had to choose one option. This creation led us to make video with two different endings, and viewer was able somehow to end the story by himself. Also, for every single video, we have made dedicated websites which corresponds with the video. This one, the first one. This one, the second one, slightly different. And there is a third one, almost, also slightly different. But okay, let's meet Emir. Emir is a guy who survived the siege of Sarajevo in 1992. When he was 9 years old, war had started in Bosnia. When he saw tanks from his balcony, he felt safe. He think, they are on my side, so that's good, but that was false feeling. Somehow, with help of his mother and I think a lot of luck, they managed to escape the city, and now they live in France. But thanks to this, Emir was able to tell us his story and some very important facts from his perspective, the perspective of the civilian who survived the war. So let's watch the video with Emir.
When I was a little boy, I saw soldiers from my balcony. You woke up and you had nothing left. No food, no electricity, no tap water. There were mortar shells and bombs falling on the streets. There were thugs creeping around houses and shops, killing and looting. After a year, my family escaped the city. I've been thinking about what I saw ever since. I know one thing, it might happen to anyone. War always happens at somebody's doorstep.
So, in this trailer, we were showing gameplay footage which was perfectly matched to the story narrated by Amir. Also, we've placed few frames of himself to make the video more truthful and to show the narrator of the story. As you can see here, it was a really good idea to make a trailer with a real survivor, because even the Washington Post magazine, newspaper, wrote about this. This is a huge mainstream newspaper. It was really nice to see this. Oh, so the last trailer I've prepared is really simple in its form, but it was the trailer that was viewed more than 500,000 times. Let's see its simplicity. Yes, this trailer is, for me, perfect example of this, that you don't need big budget and much time to do something that will bring you huge audience. The only thing that you need is an idea, and we have made it in 1 week, and we have not spent a single dollar on it, really. Everything was done in our office by our team, starting from the idea and ending with the final product. As you can see, it was a great idea to make a trailer with gameplay scenes separated by quotes and scores from many websites. Entire trailer was made with use of only our resources, our gameplay footage, our music composed by our colleague from our company, and also texts. So, that's true, you can make something effective without big budget and without making expensive cinematics. That's all I've prepared for you today. I hope you enjoyed the lecture because it was my first public speech. If you have any questions, ask me now and then let's go to a party. Thank you.
Just give me a minute, you're far.
Hello. If I got it correctly, you're a studio based in Poland.
Yes.
Has that or the game anything to do with, you know, the surviving in a besieged city? Because that triggered in my mind. I mean, as Poland was by the time of the Second World War.
Yeah.
So I think I am asking just, does it mean something personally for you as a Polish guy?
I don't think so that it does mean much for me, but it was inspired by some historical events, and the game is not located in any place. It's fiction.
Right.
Another long way.
Yeah, they are doing it on purpose. I'll get gray hair by then.
Hi.
Hi.
I just want to say that the Omega trailer is one of my favorite trailers ever.
I'm glad.
And I'm curious if you can share the costs for licensing the music, like Nights in White setting or the Omega
how
trailer.
We managed to buy them?
Yes.
Oh, I really don't know, but my friend was arranging everything and writing to the other people who have the rights to the music. So that's the... But it costs much, trust me.
Well, you get the email and you can try and convince him.
Yeah.
Thank you, George.
Hi, great work. fantastic work.
Thank you.
From a developer's perspective, did you use the only assets in game, or did you create special assets and animations for some of the trailers?
No, those are only assets from the game. So everything, we didn't make any new or strict to the trailer animations or stuff. It's everything from the game.
Okay, thank you. Talk to you more at the party. So,
thank you.
Anybody?
Hey, I noticed a lot of, let's say, negative language at the end. Was what a war is not, what a hero is not. Was that choice on purpose?
Yes, we wanted to show the hero. There was a hero, the father who saved the girl. But everyone here can be a hero, not only a soldier, you know. So that's why we wanted to say that in war, not everyone is a soldier, and all this stuff. I don't know if I said everything you want, but I tried.
Hello. I was really emotional in some of those trailers. They're really good, especially the one where Emmy. Yeah. What I want to ask is, how did you come up with the animation system in the game?
Oh, we have some animation guys in our office, but also we're doing this stuff with Xbox Kinect and some kind of software. I don't remember the name. And everything was done in our office.
So when you're starting building the trailer, do you need to play the game first in order to get the atmosphere? When you're starting building the trailer, do you need to play the game first to get a feel of it, or is the studio just showing you some gameplay snippets or giving you some information? How does the process go from they have the game to you making the trailer to convey the emotions?
No, it works like this, that we have an idea how we want to look the trailer, and then we call other company, which is doing trailers, making trailers, and then we are talking about how to make it works. So sometimes they need to play the game to see how what is the game, but mostly we are recording our gameplay, sending to them, and they are editing stuff. That's how we did.
Any last question? No one. Okay. So since David said that this was his first ever public presentation, I want us to give him a proper round of applause, please.
Thank you so much. Thanks. Bye.